Well, the moment has passed. Back to work!
G'day all, Mr. Paladin here with How a Spy Thinks number 91. And today, I want to talk about my Lutron J. Well, I do want to kind of talk about my entire favorite set, but I'll be concentrating on the pistol itself, the revolver, the sneaky git of a weapon, made for sneaky gits who like to sneak around and stab things, pretty much. It is the knife user's pistol. First of all, let's have a look at its stats. What a Lutron J is going to let you do is it's going to give you plus 40 cloak. It's going to give you plus 15 cloak on hit. So that's hit with a shot, not just any hit. And for all of this, it's going to cost you 20% of the gun's damage. And that's quite significant when it comes to the revolvers. So what we have here is a weak damage revolver in a game that revolves around doing damage. Everything is about damage. It doesn't matter if you're trying to meet the objective or you're trying to slay that nemesis. If you're not killing things, you're not doing anything. While existing in an area just to scare people off, that's more impressive for something like a heavy who's sitting on the point rather than a spy who's dancing around in enemy territory. Being out of position is where spy exists. Spies like to go deep behind the enemy lines, see what we can get, assist our team, and the absolute last thing you want to do when you're behind enemy lines is to decloak at an inappropriate time. Because decloaking can be loud, but if you watch out for the other sounds in the game, you can get away with a pretty close decloak sometimes. People can get distracted, or there can be a big global announcement coming across the comms and you just don't hear the decloak. But if you ever have to decloak with no cloak meter, it is massively loud. So we're going to be trading our revolver damage for more cloak, or the ability to cloak, or the ability to choose better when we want to come out of cloak, rather than being forced, like having a gun to your own head and decloaking when you don't want to. Giving us the ability to pick and choose more situations that we want to be in and avoid the ones that are gonna get us smushed. The cloak meter itself is never going to kill an enemy. You are not gonna walk in front of a heavy and say, "Haha, I have a full cloak meter, look at it drain your life down." No. No. Cloak itself does not kill people, but it is how you use the cloak. Unless an enemy is highly paranoid, they are not shooting in every corner and they're not spraying flames around the entire map. So if you combine a good movement with the ability to be cloaked whenever you want, you should avoid most splash damage. Or if you do incidentally get hit, you've already got options in your head for where you're planning to go. So the minor bumps are no big deal. It doesn't matter if an enemy sees you for a split second, you're going to go into cloak. And hopefully you're already picking the situations where perhaps only the target is the person who could know that you're a spy. And it's just going to be a one-on-one and you'll avoid the damage you'll get away. The Lutron J is going to help us with the number one killer of spies who are out of position these days. Imagine it. You're deep behind the enemy lines. You've got the perfect disguise. You're staying out of eyesight. But an enemy who spawned just a moment ago and they rode the teleporter, they turned the corner and just shot you in the face. You had no idea they were coming. You can't see through walls, but they can. Ever since the introduction of the spawning war hacks in order to aid players in finding out where their team is positioned, it's been bad for spies. Spies with a disguise will show up on enemy spawning warhacks, and anyone with half a brain can have a look around when they spawn, and you can pick out the spy either by having your name, having a duplicate name, or they're just out of position from the rest of your team. They look suspicious right from the get-go. Now you can either use voice comms and tell your team about it, or you can take care of the spy yourself. Either way, the Lutron J is going to make it so that you are not up on that spawning warhack very often. You are either cloaked or you are uncloaked only for a brief moment before getting that stab and getting away. And sure, some could opt against this by taking the cloak and dagger instead of the Lutron J and an Invis Watch, but I like to keep flowing in my movement, rather than being statically defined to one part of the map. If I can keep moving around, I get to choose more situations that I want to be a part of, and get out of the bad ones as quickly as possible. Some people take it a step further and opt to take the Lutron J with a cloak and dagger to further enhance its cloaking, which is all well and good, that does get you around the map, but you don't get to pick up metal or ammo while you are cloaked. With an Invis Watch Lutron J combination, you can stay permanently cloaked in a couple of situations. Firstly, you get the ability that an Invis Watch spy gets to be able to remain cloaked on a dispenser. Doesn't matter the dispenser, but with a Lutron J, you're going to have a little bit more wiggle room and you don't have to stay absolutely glued to that dispenser, giving you a quasi cloak and dagger when there's a dispenser around. Gotta be careful, that engineer does come back and forth to his dispenser, so he could give you a bump, and they don't like that, do they? Any large ammo pack spawn will give you the same ability as a cloak and dagger. One, just one. You can stay there until it respawns. Your cloak meter will not run out no matter how much you move around, so long as you are the one picking up that ammo pack. Likewise, if there are two medium ammo packs in one place, you can stay indefinitely cloaked by consuming both of them. You just go from one to another, with each one providing you about half a cloak meter worth. Lastly, you get the spoils of war. If there is a dead body, you get to pick up a medium pack off of it, especially if you stab them in the back, you'll get it straight away. But also be on the lookout for fragments of engineers' machines that are left on the ground. That bonus metal converts into ammo, and it refills cloak meters super fast. Don't pick it all up unless you need it, or you want to deny it from the engineer, and you'll be able to stay cloaked for a very long time. The cloak and dagger users will be jealous, because they have to watch on helplessly as the engineer comes back and picks up the scraps to rebuild, unless they want to come out of cloak and expose themselves. And it is true. Another reason I take the Lutron J is because my aim is not fantastic. If you have perfect aim, go ahead and take an ambassador, only get headshots, finish every enemy off with one or two shots. Perfect. Nobody will be upset if they see their team spy just completely popping off with an ambassador or any of the high damage guns. But for me, I miss. I unfortunately miss a lot. A combination of old age and the fact that spy's shots are not accurate past the first shot if you keep the trigger down. You have to wait a cooldown before it becomes accurate again. The Lutron J, just like any of the revolvers, is a good finisher, so if you see something on low health, go ahead and pop a shot or two at them. You'll probably get them killed. Razorbacks are going to have an advantage on you, as you are going to need to land 4 shots to kill them unless you happen to random crit or are extremely close. And while I use it from time to time, the Lutron J is the only item a spy has that will synergize with a dead ringer. Its ability to cloak on hit and extend the cloak time both passively help a dead ringer. Unfortunately, while you're on a dead ringer, you are probably wanting more spy gun gameplay anyway, so you probably want a gun that's going to be dealing more damage. Every item in a spy's kit is situational, but I find the most situations I can deal with happen with the loadout that I favor. My Invis Watch now passively works with the Lutron J. My Invis Watch reduces my damage while I'm under cloak, which helps out the kunai. My Invis Watch can be resupplied from the damage fragments from engineer stuff that the sapper is going to give me. Because I'm not worried about critical hits, the Lutron J is going to work with the sapper to help shoot down sapped items. It is going to work with the kunai, because the kunai is going to give me the ability to have extra health, so I can take the weaker shots with the Lutron J with the chance of killing a much bigger target, as they might not be able to shoot me if I'm in a nice high position. So all in all, out of all the different possible combination of spy equipment, I find that this set has the most synergy, and I can get myself into more and more situations and get myself out of more and more situations than any of the other combination of items. And it is absolutely true that nothing else really beats the feeling of surfing that critical damage rocket with a dead ringer to get the stab on that sniper or something. But that happens so few and far between that I'm not going to adjust every game I play with a loadout that works so often for just the niche situational epic trick stab montages. In fact, in this clip, you'll see me doing quite well as a spy, and not one trick stab has happened. You heard it here. It's not about the trick stab, folks. Although if you like to try and push for trick stabs, having over spy's base 125 health is situationally advantageous. Go for them trick stabs if that's what you want to do. Set it to epic music like I have done in the past. But as time goes on, I'm much more comfortable with the old reliable. Latron J, InvisWatch, Kunai, Sapper. It's good for what ails you, and I find I only need to change it out if something situationally happens in a game or a map that favors something else. The one downside of the loadout, and the reason why you might not want to use it as a new spy, is the fact that you start at the base 70 health. So until that first stab, you are at a disadvantage of having another knife. But it's okay, my lads and lasses, because the Latron J has you covered. Go ahead and change out any knife you want with the Latron J, and it doesn't mind. Sure, it's weaker in its shots. It's got the 20% weakness to the other pistols at least, because some of them also have advantages to get criticals at a time of need. But, and this is a big but, its upside abilities are never situational. You are always going to be getting that extra cloak, whether you like it or not. And which spy does not like having cloak when they need it? The one challenge mode for spies out there is to try and play a game without using cloak whatsoever as a realistic spy. And the spy who did it and uploaded it to YouTube did a fantastic job, but even he admits it took an entire year to get the footage. So thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. I'll stick to my favorite, Latron J. If you like this video, be sure and check out my other How a Spy Thinks videos, or the more comedic How a Spy Thonks. Be sure and give us a like, a subscribe, or give us a comment as to which weapons you like best.